Hey guys, what's up? I hope you guys are having a great day. My name is Hadit, and today we'll be checking out some RBGs. Skype-less RBGs is how I call them. Because, well, it is kind of true. They are kind of Skype-less. And, like I said before, it's a novelty that I've seen Skype-less RBGs here. And, yeah, right now we're in Twin Peaks. And the strategy for Twin Peaks is actually pretty similar to the strategy of Warsong Gulch. It's a flat carry map. Whoa. Someone's getting the bomb on him. It's a flat carry map like Warsong Gulch, where strategies are pretty similar. For example, the leaving the rogue and mage in the flak room so you can stop the FC is a pretty familiar strat. Then another shot that you can do is blanketed. This warlock is rank 1. He like blanketed the cast that I was going to do, which was Cyclone. But we're just swiping them, which is all good. It's not really a really high rated team. And right now we're honestly just I don't know, cleaning them up. But yeah, as far as strategy goes for this map, you really want to have somebody in the back if you can to slow the, to slow the FC down. And then if you slow the FC down, why am I not dead? Oh my god, I'm dead. No, am I undead? Undead still not anymore. Damn it. That was weird. I don't know. I keep getting interrupted, guys, because this is a live commentary and sometimes I have to shift thoughts into like surviving or healing somebody ASAP. So that's why you hear me sometimes. So yeah, we have a rogue FC right now, and the rogue FC is, as you can see right now, he is a burst of speed rogue. And what a burst of speed rogue is that he's specced into a 70% movement speed pretty much all the time. So he spams that ability, and even though it costs a lot of energy, he doesn't really care, because if he's the FC, all he needs to do is run for his life. So right now all we're doing is trying to chase the FC. Now we're killing stragglers. Mindlessly chasing the FC sometimes is not the best idea. What you can do is always pick off the people that are falling behind. For example, this Ellie Shaman is getting killed while we run towards the FC. And this priest is still on angel form. I would have canceled angel form to try to get a quick rest, as quick as rest as possible. But he chose not to. So as far as comp, you want about 3 healers. Druid is really not the best choice for healers right now, because they're not powerful as all the other ones. Let's drink of the sphere. Cop, don't die on me, man. Watch this rest. I'm gonna troll res. Where is he? Where did he? Oh, I can't res anymore. Oh, this guy's cooked. Why did he jump to us? I'm bursting. DPSing. Kill. Come on, let me get the killing blow. Oof. 24k. I'm feared. I'm going tree. Enough DPS. I need to keep my DPS up. Oh my god, this is really bad. Our rogue is getting hit really hard, actually. And we have a lot of people here, so I don't know what to do. I mean, we should be fine. I guess there's only one person on a rogue. That's why he's surviving, because or else I don't think somebody can keep a rogue that long, unless he's a god. I'm staying right here just in case, because I'm kind of scared that they'll get a cap. This priest tried to fear me. I think he missed it. I don't know. At the end, their entire group here. I think I should go back. I'm gonna go back. I need to help with RC. And Godfire is getting owned. That means that there's another person there. So I'm going back. Sometimes you have to take one for the team. And in this point, I think you just have to analyze your position, because you see one. It's a rogue, and rogues aren't really tanky. They can escape. But as far as tanking goes, there's no way. So right now I'm just hoping that, oh, we'll get a cap. Well, I was taking one for the team, but we still were able to get a quick couple here on this on this team. I was a little scared because the Rook was dipping down, and Godfather, which is a warrior we were playing with, and the RBG leader, he was getting killed too. That means there were 2+ people on the near my FC, so I was just trying to protect them from that. So right now we're just trying to proceed to get the second cap, because even if you have, if you're one up in caps, it doesn't mean that it's over. It means that you are close to winning, but if the other team gets one cap, it's pretty much over. So let's see what we can do here. They have a lot of people here fighting in the middle. I don't know if they have given up or what. I guess they haven't given up. They shouldn't give up. Even if you're one down, you should never give up like that. So our Rogue has a flag already, and he's already midway map. Oh, and the droid already picked it up. I'm gonna help the warlock. He's getting hit really hard right now. Changing his fear. I'm feared again. There we go. Dispelling is pretty important in our RPGs, like especially to healers. I honestly save my dispels for healers itself, for example if they're getting feared, because if they get a really effective CC on the other healer, it can become really dangerous. But right now we're just swiping them. Our Rook seems to be getting a little bit of heat. Where's he at? Oh, he's right next to us. Good. I'm feared still. That's why I wasn't able to see it. Alright, I'm gonna stay this time with our FC, because I don't want them to die. Let's see. I keep saying let's see too much, guys. You guys gotta like give me like a wristband to like flick every time I see a let's see. I say a let's see. That's like 2 already. So this Rogue is fighting in style right now. Look at this transmog. Look at this Rogue's transmog. He looks like Cannibal or Hannibal. I have my classic gold challenge mode transmog. Oh, here's those warlock. They have 2 people here, so it was a good choice that I came back. I got gripped down, which is not good at all. I'm trying to come back up because I need to keep my Rogue up. There's just no way that's happening, that he's not. He is not dying under my watch, pretty much. So seems like we're doing okay. We just killed the warlock. I'm gonna rebuff this Rogue. I'm gonna put mine down my mushroom. Start loading him up, keeping the warrior up as well, because he's the one who's gonna kill the DPS with the Rogue. And there, I'm gonna hit a little bit hard, but the DK is almost dead, and the only target remaining is the shaman. So we're just picking them off one by one. If they would have all come in a group, we would have been in a lot of trouble. But they decided to like be unorganized and join one by one. And that's what pretty much guaranteed us the win. And the person dies. I come on the bottom, see if somebody wants to grab the flag. But they don't. And we get a second cap. That's pretty good. These RPGs, guys, or these RPGs are an experiment. So if you guys do like this live commentary RPG series, the Skypeless RPGs, please let me know in the comments. I read them all, and yeah, it's like some feedback is always appreciated. So we kept our team up. Godfather is running and alive. And if I get out of combat, I can use my mount, go back to the fight. There we go. I think that at this point they gave up. Yeah, they left. Well, they left. and that means that this video is coming to an end. We're about to cap. So I hope you guys did enjoy this live commentary. My thoughts are a little bit scattered, but that's because it's a live commentary and we're RBGing, so I have to pay attention. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys later.